CommonLit's assignment reports allow you to view trends in student data so that you can make informed choices as you plan out your instructional next steps. The top of the page gives you a quick snapshot of overall assignment trends at the class level. On this particular assignment, I can see that my students scored lower than average. Specifically, they need help with their short answer responses, as most of them scored a 2 out of 4. Looking at the score breakdown gives me more information about student groups by performance. These students are doing well. I'm going to assign them a more challenging text next time. These students struggled. I'm going to keep them in mind as I look more closely at the data. They may need some additional support for the next assignment. If you have assigned guided reading mode, you'll be able to view the data in the guiding questions table. Here you can see just how many attempts it took students to answer each guiding question correctly. Here, I can see that students really struggled with guiding question 3. This is the part in the text in which the author refers to background information about the United States government that my students are not familiar with, and the sentence structure is very complex. As a next step, I should review this section with my students, perhaps with some close reading strategies to unpack complex sentences. I can see that some students breezed right through these questions. Since guided reading mode is a scaffolding tool for differentiation, I might consider challenging those students by removing that scaffold and not assigning them the guiding questions on their next assignment. I also noticed that a couple of students made more than one attempt on every guiding question, and often 3 or more attempts. These are students who will need extra attention and support in the next lesson. CommonLit also gives you the opportunity to dig deeper into assessment question trends. I noticed that many of my students struggled with question 2, which is a Part B question that asks for evidence to support the answer to Part A. I need to give my students plenty of practice with identifying the most relevant evidence to support an answer. I also noticed that Yasmin, Brian, and Carlos struggled with most or all assessment questions. I'll want to work with these students to review the questions they struggled with the most. Then I can give them a chance to revise their responses by clicking the Unsubmit button so they can implement my feedback and resubmit their work. In the future, I might try assigning these students a lower level text to build relevant background knowledge before they read more complex grade level texts like this one. I can also encourage them to use CommonLit's annotation tool to ask questions and summarize what they're reading. I can read and respond to students' annotations on the Student Annotations page. CommonLit's Read Aloud tool might also help these students focus on comprehension and note-taking as they follow along with the text. Once I've graded all of my student responses, I can release their scores so that they can see how they performed. If you chose not to assign any assessment questions when you created your assignment report will look a little different. In this case, you'll be able to view a summary of student annotations and, if you assigned them, your guided reading mode data. Spending time reviewing student data will really help you make the right instructional choices to increase student achievement. Thanks so much for choosing CommonLit, and happy teaching!